So you want to use a specialized mouse with your Mac only to find that there's limited or no official support for your mouse and Apple doesn't really give you a lot of options. Fortunately, you can use any mouse with a Mac. All that it takes are a few extra steps to get things up and running. In this example, I'm using the Razer Naga Pro V2, but the same process should work for any mouse. They're all kind of the same in this regard. So the first thing I want to do is steer your attention to download an app called Steer Mouse. There is a 30-day free trial, but it does cost $20 as a one-time purchase to officially license the app. I know that's extra money to spend, but in this case, with the incredibly limited support on Apple computers for, you know, third-party mice, I really think that $20 is absolutely worth it. And I know there are free options like Carabiner, but in my experience, Steer Mouse has been the simplest and most reliable app that I've used. I really ran into like a lot of roadblocks with the other applications, and this one is just like quick, instant. You can do all kinds of really cool and really fun stuff with it. Once you download Steer Mouse, just drag the icon to your applications folder and then open it. As is typical with macOS, you might get a pop-up notification that asks you to enable some permissions in your security settings. Go ahead and do that if it asks you to. And now this is what the Steer Mouse interface looks like. It's pretty simple. You can select your mouse in the upper right. Depending on what you're using, some mice might show up twice, like my Naga Razer shows up separately as a Bluetooth mouse or as a wireless mouse if I'm using the dongle, and I did have to configure the buttons separately, basically duplicate my settings for each of those different devices, which was super easy, but it's just something to be aware of if you wonder why your mouse is showing twice in the menu. Now, the part that really matters, which is assigning buttons, is super simple. All you need to do is put your mouse cursor on top of this image of a mouse. It does not matter if this mouse does not look like the one that you're using. Just put your cursor there and press any button or click any button on your mouse, and you're gonna see it light up in the list on the left-hand side. This is a great way to figure out which button numbers are which from the computer's point of view, because on my mouse, for example, I can do the left click, which is primary click, the right click, which is secondary, the middle click, and then if I press the one, this button has a whole number pad on the side here, keys 1 through 12. If I press the one that has a one on it, it's button number 4. So if you don't know which button is which, it can be very difficult and confusing to assign different actions to them. So again, all you need to do is put your cursor here, click the button that you want to mess with, and it's going to light up to let you know which button it is on the mouse. And if you have a mouse like mine that has a whole bunch of different buttons, it'll just give you, you know, a couple different pages of buttons to go through. From here, we can choose the button we want to assign and then select an option from the menu. So button number 4 is the one I'm going to use here. In this case, I want to select a keyboard shortcut, but you do have the option to use all kinds of different system commands and different controls. For what I wanted to do here with the 12 keys on the side of my mouse, I basically wanted that to correspond with the number row on my computer keyboard. So I select keyboard shortcut and then just type in whatever I want that key to do. In this case, I just want it to be number 1, click OK, and now button 4, which is the button that has a 1 on it on my mouse, is just number 1 on my computer. So it acts the same as if I were pressing 1 over here. Same thing right there. And you might have noticed you can also add modifiers. So if you want to do Command, Shift, Option, Control, you can kind of do a sequence of commands there. And this is just keyboard shortcuts. Like I mentioned, you have all kinds of different applications. You can do like system control stuff where you can basically have all kinds of very specific commands to different buttons on whatever mouse you're using. Once you've got your buttons assigned, you can then click the wheel icon to adjust your scroll wheel. In my case, the default settings were perfect, so I did not need to adjust anything here. The next page is cords, which even if you're using a wireless mouse, you can still have cords on your mouse. So basically, this is like multiple buttons at once. So the same way that if you're playing music, you can have multiple notes come together to create a chord. You can have multiple button clicks come together at the same time to create a chord. So if we add a new chord here, you can kind of see like, you know, the right button plus the middle button at the same time would be a chord. So that can be changed according to whatever you need. Obviously, this can be huge for a lot of productivity workflows and tasks. The cursor tab is next, and this is where you probably will want to make some adjustments. So if you're unsure of what anything does, you can click this little question mark and the info box will show up that explains what each setting does, because it is like, what's the difference between acceleration and sensitivity is a little bit confusing. But at the same time, don't be afraid to just, you know, move things around until the mouse feels the way that you like. And as you're using these sliders, don't be afraid about hurting anything, because if you accidentally do something that's too crazy, like right now I can't see my cursor at all, it's too fast, Steer Mouse is warning me. it's going to revert back in 5 seconds, or I could just press return on the keyboard to automatically do it. And now my mouse cursor is back. So if you accidentally do kind of mess up a little bit, there's really nothing to worry about. And that means you can really spend your time dialing this in until it feels exactly right for you. The next two tabs aren't super necessary most of the time. The device tab just lets you basically deal with things if you're having some kind of issue or something's not showing up. And the license tab deals with the app itself. So that's where, you know, if you use the trial and you purchase a license or you want to update it or uninstall it, that's where you would go over here. But you shouldn't need to deal with these tabs most of the time. And that's pretty much the basics of how to get any mouse working on a Mac using Steer Mouse. But we can also take things a little bit further. So if you notice on the button menu right up here, it says default. By default, that is just the profile that you're assigning everything to. But I can click edit, and now I can actually create more profiles for my mouse, and they can be application specific. So you can actually create a ton of different custom profiles for your mouse. I bought the Naga Pro to use with Final Fantasy 14 because it has a lot of buttons on it, and using a lot of buttons in that game is incredibly helpful. But as someone who edits a lot of videos and does a lot of live streaming, I realized this mouse could be a huge help for things like Final Cut Pro or Ecamm Live. So what I can do is click on edit, click the plus icon, and now I can scroll down and I want to create a Final Cut profile. And now I can create a set of actions that apply specifically to Final Cut Pro. So for example, when I'm editing video, I can have layers of video, layers of audio. If I want to slice through all those at the same time, that's Shift Command B. I put the playhead over, slice, I have to press those three keys. You're sort of doing this stretchy hand exercise the whole time. Instead, say I want button number 4, which is currently number 1 here. I want to be a keyboard shortcut. B is the blade tool, but I also need Command and Shift. So now, anytime I press button number 1 here, it's gonna be Shift Command B, okay. And now, if we go into Final Cut Pro, this is a project where all the files have been deleted, so just ignore that. But right here, you can see there is a video file, and an audio layer. And if I just press number 1 on my mouse, it sliced through all of them. So now, instead of having to do that, you know, finger yoga over there, I can just assign any of my most common used things like undo, redo, add markers, all of that stuff I can just assign to my mouse. What's really cool about this is since these profiles are app specific, they change on their own depending on which app you're using. So if I'm in Final Cut Pro, button number 1 on my mouse will be Shift Command B. I can literally be in Final Fantasy here, click number 1 and it's doing the number 1 action, and then I can slide over here into Final Cut Pro, and now it is Shift Command B, and I didn't have to do anything. There was no editing magic that took place there. So now you can kind of see how creative you can get, how many different ideas you can have with this application, how to use your mouse. So for example, I do a lot of live streaming. So if I want to use Ecamm Live, which is my streaming software of choice, I can create an Ecamm profile. And now my mouse can essentially be like a stream deck. I can switch between camera angles, scenes, I can add graphics, I can change all that stuff, play sound effects just from my mouse without having to reach to my keyboard or do anything else. So the possibilities are pretty endless, and you can switch between profiles, add, remove profiles anytime super easily. The one thing to be aware of though, the very important thing, is that a lot of mice like mine have RGB lighting effects, and unfortunately Steer Mouse and similar applications do not let you control or adjust your RGB settings. So in the case of my mouse, which is a Razer mouse, there is an app called Razer macOS, which is free. It is not officially supported by Razer, but it does let you adjust the RGB settings on Razer devices. It does have support for the original Naga Pro and a bunch of other mice and devices, which is nice, but it does not have support for the Naga Pro V2. So for now, I'm just not going to be able to adjust my RGB lighting on my mouse. Otherwise though, in the areas that it really matters and the really important things, like how the mouse functions, this has really helped open up a pretty huge amount of awesome options. And I hope that it also helps you get the most out of using whichever mouse you want to use with your Mac. And I'm also not gonna forget to thank everyone who helps support my channel through Patreon and YouTube channel memberships. The perks are the same across YouTube and Patreon, so join whichever you prefer if you feel like giving the channel a bit of extra support.